While COVID was starting to rage on the 20th of March 2020, the Rotary Club of Chira was put in place. RI chartered them. And today we're going to witness as they change leadership to their second president. We know that it's a very important time for Rotary, for us to change leadership as we go into the new Rotary year. Let us witness today as this very vibrant club that is 2 years old exchanges their chains and becomes one of the biggest numbers and the youngest club that has 60 members today.
Thank you. dear guest of honor, before you, our protective, prospective Rotarians, they are ready to be inducted even this evening.
Fellow Rotarians, Rotractors, our guests, this evening, it is such a great honor to join you in celebrating change of leadership, but officiating at such an activity which is seen as the biggest moment in the names which have been read, signifying growth, but also to show how Rotary is changing lives. The appreciation from these members who are joining us this evening, having been invited by friends, relatives, and colleagues at their workplaces to come and join the biggest service organization in the world, which is giving smiles to so many people in the world, is a sign that what we are doing is the best to humanity. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you and congratulate you on such a very big occasion. I'd like to thank the director membership, Grace, who is my wife. Some people get jealous whenever I say that she's my wife, but true, she's my wife. And I'm so proud of her for the great work you've done, my wife, Grace. But also have my son, Edward, if you can stand up, Kasato, for recognition. That is the Anne, who is a Rotarian in his own right. I'd like to thank the director of the district membership chair, Ronald Kawadwa, for the job well done. It's their time, their resources, which have made the Rotary Club of Chira to what it is today. A decision which took the few members who were invited when this club was in formation, and today we celebrate them because we are seeing a very strong and vibrant club. My activity I'm going to undertake now is a sign of hope, is a sign of confidence in this club, but it comes from the leadership. Be mindful of the needs of others. MG Pika Cable, come and pick a pin very fast. And whoever you're inducting, please say a word. I congratulate you on joining the Rotary Club of Chira. This rappel pin, which I've put on your jacket, is to welcome you in the biggest service organization in the world. Always wear this pin with the biggest smile, because you've taken so many smiles to people in the world. Be proud to mention to your friends, relatives, and family, and your colleagues at your workplace, that you've joined the most prestigious organization in the world called Rotary, and today we recognize you as a Rotarian of this club. Use your time and resources in giving a smile to so many people in this world. I'm so honored that I'll see you inviting so many, and you're going to do more to reach out and identify challenges in communities. I believe you're going to be a strong pillar in this club, having gone through the mentorship. And thank you, and I wish you all the best. Let's receive Abdul Karim as a member of the Rotary Club of Chira. Uh, Abantu kani barunji, abantu kani barunji, abantu kani barunji. Kani benjenjeta, can you stand? Kani benjenjeta, kani benjenjeta. Abantu kani barunji, abantu kani barunji, abantu kani barunji. Can you do like this? Kani benjenjeta. That one means that you're all glowing. Let's enjoy Rotary. Rotary is fun and fellowship. It builds you in confidence and public speaking. It connects you to your old friends and make new friends. It is one of the biggest families you can join and appreciate. You reach out to communities, identify needs, and we come back together to exchange ideas and take action. This evening, you're becoming more members and people of action. Thank you so much. We wish you the best as you join the biggest service organization in the world. Each and every one of you, you come with different strengths. You come from different classifications. We believe each and every one of you is going to become a change maker. Thank you so much, and may the good Lord bless you all.
Members of the Rotary Club of Chira, let's give our guest of honor a round of applause. He traveled this morning for the burial of our DG ND, the late Agre Kankunda, but he made sure that he's here with us this evening. Guest of honor, the theme of this year was Rotary opens opportunities. And indeed, the year did not come alone with opportunities alone, but with some challenges as well, especially the COVID-19 pandemic. Guest of honor, first of all, I would like to salute the Rotarians who came with the vision of starting the Rotary Club of Chira. Allow me in a special way appreciate PAG Edward Kakembo and AGE Petra Sansa from the Rotary Club of Kampala Tese Islands, our mother club, and the Rotary Club of Namugongo, who jointly mothered this club. I would also like to thank them for entrusting me with the responsibility of steering a group of people, businessmen, managers, to start the Rotary Club of Chira. And to you, members of the Rotary Club of Chira, thank you for giving me the opportunity to be your charter president. It has been an awesome moment working with you. You have been wonderful people. Guest of honor, district leaders, and all my fellow Rotarians and guests. Today we are here to celebrate the end of my 2 years of top leadership at club level, where I had the privilege to serve as a World Connecting President in 2019-2020, and as an Opportunity President 2020-2021. A journey that started on the 2nd of July 2019. I have had the privilege of being polished and sharpened by the finest breed of Rotarian. PAG Edward Kakembo, PAG Ronald Kawadua, PAG Simon Siona, AG Ismail, AG E. Petrus Sansa, and our own MD Rotarian Mamerito. Thank you so much for your guidance that you have provided me during my term of leadership of this club. I was humbled by your choice of appointing me to serve as the charter president of the Rotary Club of Chira. Thank you for the faith and the trust in me to provide leadership to the Rotary Club of Chira at its infancy stage. Thank you, board members. I would like to perform a small function. Kindly bear with me, board members, before you take your seats. I would like to kindly appreciate you for your efforts, the dedication, and your time that you have given to serve in service. Before me, I have a simple token of appreciation in recognition of your outstanding performance.
We shall begin with P.E. Medi Lutaya. For avoidance of not mentioning your name right, allow me to call you Rotarian Amos Bonazi Kalumba. Next we have Florence Mirembe. The rest of us can be just clapping. Then we have Lillian Ntulo coming in next. Once you're getting yours, please try to smile and remove your mask so that the picture is very nice. Ben Sapuka, you're coming in next, Rotarian. Ladies and gentlemen, join me as we welcome Rotarian Juliet Namara Muvawala, coming in next. Show a sign of excitement when you get your token from the president. Patrick Mundwa, coming in next, Rotarian. Ladies and gentlemen, coming next is Rotarian Grace Nagawa Kasato. As if that is not enough, we have another Rotarian that is getting a token of appreciation, Joyce Kalumba. Okay, if you know these people, please give them some hugulations. Ladies and gentlemen, next will be James, is it Joloba? What a name that is nice for a Rotarian. Next, ladies and gentlemen, is Rotarian Moses Mubiru. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have another powerful Rotarian here, Gideon Katelega. So, ladies and gentlemen, I've had this name for several times, Millicent Bulafu. The other is Anthony Okimat Opolot. Who is going to hand over to him? Can we have, yes, please do the honors. And ladies and gentlemen, coming next is Johnny Bosco Ettore. Is he here with us? Or is that all, Mr. President? Okay.
Allow me recognize the following category for some outstanding performance. As I mentioned, Rotarian John Bosco Ettore is getting a token of appreciation, having been a Rotarian who has brought the most members to the club.
Okay.
And Rotarian Mamerito Mugerwa, thank you for honoring your promise and kindly stand up for recognition. As if offering the hall was not enough, Major Donor Rotarian Mamerito Mugerwa offers us here a public address system and a DJ at all our fellowships. Thank you so much for that kind heart. May God bless you abundantly. Rotarian Amos Kalumba, Rotarian Florence, Rotarian James Joloba, Rotarian Lillian, and Millicent. Thank you for leading the way in becoming true Rotarians. And I would like to appreciate PDG Ken for being a member of the Rotary Club of Chira.
That is a special thank you to you, major sponsor, major donor. Thank you so much for the big hearts. And before you leave, there is also another special token for you for having a large heart towards humanity. A round of applause to Rotarian Mamerito. Thank you so much. God bless you.
And then we also would like to recognize, appreciate the Rotary Club of Namugongo for mothering us.
That is the Rotary Club of Sese. Thank you so much. Please, if you want to clap for these people, please clap. Thank you so much. God bless you. The Rotary Club of Namugongo, you're coming next. Oh, yes. You can see the life with the Rotary Club of Namugongo. Thank you for standing with the Rotary Club of Kira. We still have other tokens of appreciation from the Mr. President. Thank you so much. Ismael Dungu Mukasa, a round of applause. Thank you so much.
And the other is IPP Ajuna, Albert Ajuna, for his dedicated support to the Rotary Club of Chira.
The protocol was already organized and recognized, but allow me, President Anthony, to thank you so much for the year well done and for increasing the membership to 60 members, and I think you deserve a great round of applause for that. My task was to request the guest of honor to be here, but Rotary protocol demands that we introduce him, and thereafter I request him firmly accept to come and be at the officiation of the installation of the incoming president, our good friend had made him. Mr. Governor Kenneth Wycliffe Mugisha, our guest of honor this evening. That hand clap is welcome, the local chairman. Please welcome an international man to come and speak to us. Ted is married to Judy, and between them, with all the energy that he has, they have two children. Join me once again to welcome PDG Ken Wycliffe Mugisha.
You know, I don't know whether you can tell about someone's energy when you have not experienced the same. Thank you very much, First Assistant Governor Ronald. It is truly an honor to join you this evening when an outstanding president, a person who has taken over 2 years, leading, guiding, supporting a club which started information, the Rotary Club of Chira today, which has grown to over 60 members. Anthony, you always make me proud. I'd like to invite Anthony to come and join me, and at the same time invite Mehdi, who is smartly dressed, and I would like to invite the outgoing Assistant Governor Ismael to stand next to Mehdi to see how drafts are part of our... Come, come. This week's membership chair also joined me here. I think because of observing the SOPs, these are enough. Anthony, please remove peacefully with a smile, and you can only do that while exposing your face. And that smile is what we need. In reality, one time they said Umsaji Agenda, and a man never wait. But this one is going for real. And this is the last time we'll be having this chain. Thank you, Anthony, for your selflessness, for your love to humanity, but also to your club. I would like to invite Mehdi's wife to come and join us. When it comes to family, Rotary competes with our spouses. And it's that competition which can even create a rift in the family. I'd like to believe that receiving a president in your home, and this evening signifies your acceptance for Mehdi to share that time which you value most with communities through his work, through his passion, through his resources, and love to make a difference in people's lives. You're going to support him. Please be there to comfort him. Friends, now if we can all stand to receive a person I would call my son. I have mentored Mehdi, and I'm proud of you as a person. Mehdi has hustled his way through. Individually, when his father was out of the country, Mehdi has taken care of so many people, right from when he was still a student. And I believe it is this same passion he's going to use to guide and support this club as the next president of this club. And yesterday, those of you who listened to the president, if you care to, he's always struggling to say the word 2020. And yesterday he did the same mistake. He said, 2020. Today, let's receive the true president of the Rotary Club of Chira for the year 2021-2022. I'm listening for Obushija Wanje, please, DJ. Medica Nimurunji, Medica Nimurunji, Medica Nimurunji. Kana yenjenjeta. Medica Nimurunji, Medica Nimurunji, Medica Nimurunji. Kana yenjenjeta. And secretary, if you can pass over the gong and bell. Mehdi, please, you're also going to receive the instruments of power, and that is the gong and the bell, to preside over fellowship, to guide and support your club, to promote discipline while presiding over fellowship. And please, let's have that maiden open the fellowship this evening. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you so much, guest of honor, Past District Governor Kenneth Wycliffe Mugisha. I'd like to take the oath as follows. I, Mehdi Rutaya, do solemnly swear, pledge that I'll faithfully execute the office of the President of the Rotary Club of Chira, and that I will do the best of my ability, and to the best of my ability, support the District Governor and Rotary International, and that I'll uphold the Constitution and the bylaws of this club. So help me God. We have a very big hall.
Yes.
The hall that can sit up to 200 members.
Yes.
While observing social distance.
Yes.
So we've taken note of the SOPs that the government put through, but we've been encouraging members to come, those that can, and observe social distance. So, but also very importantly is that the agenda we have as a club has made it possible for members to stay the course.
Okay.
And also made it possible for members, for prospective members, to come and join the club. You've seen it's a club of young, dynamic and enthusiastic people.
Yes,
people
a lot have of a passion.
People have a passion.
Yes.
People who look forward to networking, people who look forward to serving the community.
Yeah.
So with a diversity of classifications and majorly young people. By young people, I mean between the ages of 30 to about 45.
Yes.
The club is an ideal destination for that corporate,
yes,
established Ugandan who has the passion for service and has some money to give to the vulnerable.
Interesting. With 61 members, that's very good for the Rotary International TRF. And I imagine that your club members will definitely collect money. I have one last question. What is it that you're going to give your club, your community during your year?
Well, thank you. Maybe before I answer that question, I need to bring it to your attention that all the club members are PHF sustaining.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah. We've gone a long way, and we do it from the time we are bringing new members.
Yeah.
To make it clear to them that the reason as to why Rotary exists is because of the foundation.
Yes.
And the foundation is the backbone for projects.
Yes.
And because of the foundation, the numbers from the members and then their respective contributions. So it's something that we inculcate into membership induction and orientation as well as development. On what we have set to do in the Rotary year 2021-2022, first of all, I want to tell you that I have a very
big and formidable board.
Okay.
Several directorates.
Yes.
And we have sat down and carefully thought about the goals for the year. And the goals are simple, specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound, because we only have a year to do this.
And the COVID.
Yeah, and this is what we have done.
Yeah.
We have promised ourselves to give to the Rotary Foundation direct giving TRF of $10,000.
$10,000.
So that is looking at a minimum of 10 new PHFs.
Yes.
Currently, the club has 7 PHFs. So we are looking for.
And the rest are sustaining.
Yes, and this are sustaining.
Yes.
So we want to have 10,000 for TRF, and then we want to give 2,500 to Polio Blast. As you heard, we had set a target of $1,000 the previous year,
yeah,
and we achieved 2,300.
Yes.
So now we are putting it at 2,500 for the Rotary year. We're also envisaging a membership growth of 15 new members. As you are aware, the Rotary International President, Alex,
wants us to grow past the 1.2.
Yeah, he says do more, grow more. He wants everyone to bring a member. But we've looked at what the district has as the membership target, and we have tried to get a hybrid of the two, and we thought we wanted to get something that's sustainable. So our minimum is going to be 15 new members. I'm very optimistic that we're going to get there.
Yeah.
Because you saw so many prospects.
Yeah.
At the installation. Then our membership retention, we are looking at 90%. The target at the district is 95%. As I speak, we still have all the members. But because COVID has swept so many clubs in so many ways, some have lost over 50% of their members. We told ourselves that we're going to do everything possible to have a minimum retention of 90%. But our target at the background is 100%. We have agreed to undertake one global grant project. As I speak now, we have the project in the pipeline.
Okay.
So our target being one doesn't mean that we're going to stop at one. We have in the pipeline, we have needs assessment and feasibility that we've done on 2 hours.
What is that project?
Yeah?
What is the project?
The project that we have is a WASH project, and it is in a partnership with the Rotary Club of Bulindo.
Okay.
We are doing a WASH project for improving water and sanitation facilities to a school in our neighborhood.
Is that the $91,000 project?
Yes, exactly.
Good.
So as a club, we are partnering with them, and we're giving them $5,000.
Okay.
So that is one of the projects. And then in our immediate surrounding, we have Chira Secondary School.
Mm.
We have a short-term and a long-term project for the school.
Mm.
The short-term project is an adolescent sexual and reproductive health for the youth, for the students going there.
Mm.
We did an assessment, and the findings were so appalling.
Yeah.
School-going girls have implants. The sanitation facilities at the school are so pathetic.
Okay.
Teachers are sharing the same toilet irrespective of gender. The water facilities.
Is there a possibility of an Interact club as well?
Yeah, that's what I'm coming to, a very deplorable state. So we're doing both a short-term project and a long-term project with the school in our immediate surrounding.
Okay.
But also, the other target is we are supposed to identify and sponsor an Interact club of the same school.
Yes.
And that is going to feed into the bigger target of also having the Rotary club in our area.
Mm.
So, when it comes to building capacity of the members, we have set a target of at least 10 club officers attending district trainings. And then when it comes to visibility and participation in Rotary events, we have set a target of 15 club members participating actively in the 97th this year in Naivasha. As I speak now, we have 9 people who have paid money for the 97th this year in Naivasha. So our target is at 15, but we want to go as much as 30 members. And the most interesting thing is that our mother club is taking over the Sergeant at Arms duty at the 97th this year.
Okay.
And they have agreed to do it with their babies.
Oh.
So the members are in very high spirits to also serve at that level.
We see a lot of energy. I've seen a lot of energy, and the Sese energy that I usually see when I come to the Rotary Club of Sese.
Yes.
How have you managed to do this? And maybe my final question to allow you to answer both. How are you going to manage the numbers that they're growing, and big numbers, leadership, you have to make sure it gels. How are you supporting them?
The energy, when we're starting this club, we encourage them to visit a number of clubs. And they used to visit our mother club, the club of Kampala Sese. They like the energy. Remember, we had that before, that was before COVID, we had that monthly band. We used to go to the islands. So they were so excited with the club of Kampala Sese. So they wanted to be a replica of the mother
of the
club. And then they said, because their average age is about 31, they said they are saying that they want to be even better than the mother club.
Interesting.
The growing numbers is good for Rotary. Carol, you're a Rotarian. You know that we've been advocating for more hands.
Yes.
You know, there are so many. We've been 1.2 million Rotarian for. I've been a Rotarian for the last 27 years. Ever since I joined Rotary, we are 1.2 million Rotarians.
Yes.
Even up to now, the number rotates around 1.2 something. So we want more numbers to come and help, because the problems out there, there are so many. And this area, being that it's a Yofagini area, it's an area where they still land.
Yes.
So a number of professionals are migrating to this place. So we expect this club to grow.
Yes. We've lost a number of Rotarians on COVID. Advise Rotarians on what to do.
I want to advise fellow Rotarians to be very careful and be aware of COVID. COVID-19 is for real. These 2 days, I've lost 4 former colleagues who used to work with the Uganda Revenue Authority. They died of COVID. As I speak now, our district governor, Rosette Nabumba Nayenga, was admitted last night in Zago with COVID. And there are so many people who are suffering from COVID. In my own club, there are about 3 people who have been suffering from COVID. So, fellow Rotarians, COVID is for real. Please keep safe. We want to bank on you to support the community where we serve. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Rotarian Kakembo. Me, you'll always be. I know as we grow, as we go in Rotary, a lot of things happen. But thank you very much. It's a good club you've nurtured here. An amazing 2-year-old with 60 members. That's amazing. Thank you very much for also coming to the Rotary.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah. A couple of years ago, you would come to Kira and think it is a forest. Today, we have just witnessed a whole community become a Rotary Club. They've been here for 2 years. They are growing. They started at 40. Today, they are 60. We have not talked about community-led Rotary Clubs. But this is one of those clubs that has come out of a community. They live and stay together in one community, go to the same church, go to the same community when it comes to policing. That is how Rotary is created in some instances. We've measured many ways on how to get Rotarians into Rotary, and this is one of them. Thank you for watching the Rotary Moment. Join us again next time. But you can also catch us on Facebook at The Rotary Moment or on the YouTube channel, The Rotary Moment Show.